A good tweeter that can create a good treble is vital. In the 80s, sometime Philips made a ribbon tweeter that could maybe be used from 10 kilohertz and up. I always thought about the qualities of the ribbons, but how to make that in a more compact and more efficient packaging. And when we started the Børresen company, I had a full retake on this, and the result is this driver, where the target was to iron out where I've seen the issues, where I've seen the problems, and simply make every little bit and piece of that original Philips design a lot better. And what we can do today that they couldn't do in the 80s is that we have the neodymium magnets that makes us capable of making a more linear, much, much stronger field. That original design had some very, very good qualities. But with the arrival of the neodymium magnet, it created a whole realm of possibilities. We have also much, much better membrane materials. And the result of that is that this area of the membrane weighs less 1.5 hundredths of a gram, about maybe 50 times or 30 times less mass than a dome tweeter that is only 1/3 of the size. And because it's so light, it cannot store energy. That means that it cannot have any resonances of a dome because there's no mass to carry the resonance. There's no doubt that this type of tweeter, this concept, has the highest potential of any tweeter for the normal consumers or for the hi-fi business. It refines and adds these airy, beautiful details that is in the music, all the overtone in instruments. And without a good treble, what you are left with is like a cartoon rather than a full picture.